Hello, friends. I hope that you're having an amazing day, an amazing morning, whatever time it is, and overall an amazing week. I wanted to create this content today and talk about embracing the feminine energy and how to nurture that and nourish it, because this day and age, yes, it's amazing to be an independent woman. It's amazing that we have our rights as women and that we can stand on our own and we're able to provide for ourselves, be boss women that we are. But I also wanted to talk about how and why Heavenly Father created us as women and just the feminine side in general for everybody, and how to nourish it and strengthen it a little bit more. So come join me for just a little bit of ways to nourish the feminine energy. First way is to, first of all, be out in nature. Take some time to walk barefoot around the park, to hug a tree, even sit under a tree, or simply to grow a plant and nourish it, because the feminine energy is all about creating, nurturing, and there's a lot going on behind me, and I'm sorry about that. But everybody's having fun and enjoying life. It's amazing to me that Heavenly Father created women to multiply things. We're able to create babies, and even just not even our own children we take care of, and we multiply anything that we're given, and it's such a gift, and I think that's something that should be embraced and appreciated. So another way to nurture the feminine energy is to create. Find some time and paint or draw or sketch. It doesn't have to be amazing. It doesn't have to be good. It's just a way to nurture the creativity we have, not only as women or the feminine energy, but as human beings. It's within us all to create in some way or another, even if that is writing poetry, expressing your feelings, allowing that outlet. Another way to embrace the feminine energy is to know your worth. Know that in the scriptures it says a woman's worth is worth more than rubies. I'll quote the exact scripture so that way you can have that. The more you realize how powerful you are, you should respect your energy, preserve it. Yes, be a giver of light and love, but also respect yourself enough to preserve it and keep it safe and guard your heart. Another way is to speak your truth. Sometimes we feel like we have to hold ourselves back, or even as human beings, you know, we don't want somebody else to get offended. But if you speak your truth, I feel like other people respect you for it. Therefore, you're living in your authenticity, and your authenticity, as I always say every week, is such a beautiful thing, and it's so needed for this world. So stay true to yourself. Don't be afraid to speak your opinions, but do it in a kind way. And speak your truth. Don't be afraid to speak up if you feel like something is not right. I'm sure other people are feeling the same way. We need your voice. And lastly, know that you are beautiful and that you do not have to look like every other woman on social media, because you are beautiful just as you are, and whenever you really embrace that confidently and you know your worth, it is such an amazing and beautiful thing, not only as a woman but as a human being. And you are such a beautiful soul. You are more than your human body and the physical and the superficial. You're more than that. You're a lot deeper, and it's a lot more special, and you have a light to give. I love you guys, and this is just a short little reminder of the week that you are special and you should really nurture your soul, nurture your feminine energy. I hope that this helps. Hope if anything that I bring out of this week, at least I hope it makes you smile a little bit or feel a little inspired for the week. I love you guys. I'm sending my love and light your way.